Good morning, students. In our last class, we have completed the poem My Mother, and I hope you all have started writing the notes of that lesson. And today we are moving to the next lesson, that is from C reading. Name of the lesson is A Letter to a Friend. So if you see in your textbook, A Letter to a Friend, Hyderabad, 12/11/2012. Dear Suresh, so here who is writing the letter? Two friends are writing letter to one another here. So who is writing this letter? Ramesh is writing the letter to his friend Suresh. So what he is writing we will see. Hyderabad, 12th November 2012, Dear Suresh. So he is mentioning his friend as Dear Suresh. This is Ramesh. I apologize for not meeting you during your visit to Hyderabad last week. Unfortunately, I had a meeting in my office. I remember how we enjoyed our childhood days in Manikonda village. Every day we played together in our garden. Our family was very big. There were 12 members in our family. I remember how we played in the moonlight. Our grandma used to give us fruits and biscuits. Our grandpa used to tell us fairy tales about the princes, warriors and the village boys. So here see what he is telling. This is Ramesh. Means who is writing the letter? Ramesh is writing the letter. And he is saying, I apologize for not meeting you during your visit to Hyderabad last week. Means Ramesh is telling, apologize means feeling sorry. So he is telling sorry for not meeting Suresh when he visited to Hyderabad in last week. So unfortunately, why he didn't meet, he is giving the explanation. Unfortunately, I had a meeting in my office. So Ramesh is telling that as I was having meeting in my office, I was unable to meet you. And he is telling that I remember how we enjoyed our childhood days in Manikonda village. So Ramesh is telling that I remember our childhood days, how we enjoyed in Manikonda village. And he is explaining about his childhood. See, every day we played together in our garden. So what they used to do? They used to play in their garden. And our family was very big. There were 12 members in our family. How many members were there? 12 members were there in their family. And I remember how we played in the moonlight. And also he is telling about how they played in the moonlight, means even at night also they used to play. And their grandmother used to give them fruits and biscuits. And their grandpa used to tell fairy tales, means stories related to princes, warriors and the village boys. Now I am working at Microsoft as a software company, Hyderabad, as a computer programmer. I am married and we have a child. My wife works at Delhi, Hyderabad as a system analyst. You know, city life is quite busy. We start in the morning, leave our child at the baby care center and come back in the evening with faded faces. We hardly find time to sit together. How disgusting. We work with computers, think like computers and live like computers. We have forgotten our family. So he is explaining about his life. So where do Ramesh work? See here. Now I am working at Microsoft. So Ramesh is working at Microsoft. It is a software company in Hyderabad. And what is his designation? He is working as a computer programmer. And he is married and they have a child. And his wife also works at Dell in Hyderabad as a system analyst. And he is telling that city life is quite busy and their he is explaining about their routine. They start in the morning, and what they do, they leave their child at the baby care center and come back in the evening with faded faces, and they hardly find time to sit together. As they are very busy, they don't even find time to sit together and spend time. So he's telling how disgusting our lives are, and he's telling we work with computers and we think like computers and live like computers, and they have forgotten their family. I remember how we played gilli danda, hide and seek and kabaddi. We went for swimming in our local tank every Sunday. Here we live in an apartment where there is no room to play. Our flat is our world, just like a well for a frog. So what he is telling, he always remember how they used to play in their childhood. They used to play gilli danda, hide and seek and kabaddi. And also what they used to do, they used to go for swimming in their local tank every Sunday. But he is comparing his childhood with his present, and he is telling that we live in an apartment where there is no room to play. Means in olden days in his childhood he used to play a lot, but now in his apartment he not even find a room to play, and he feel as if their flat is their world, like just like a well for a frog. Means how a frog lives in a well and it feels as if it is its world, like that even they feel the same, as if their flat is their world. How happy we were in our school. We used to sit in the same row, did all the work together and took part in the events. I remember how Padmanabhaya sir, our class teacher, appreciated us when we got the first prize in district science fair. I remember how we went on a picnic to Koil Sagar. There we went boating. Our tour to Srishailam was memorable. Still I remember the green hills full of trees that almost touched the sky. I remember the roaring of the Krishna River at the dam. There is nothing here. I wonder at my child's silence. He always sits in front of the computer and plays games, never caring for anyone. So he is telling how happy we were in our school days, and he is telling about their school. They used to sit in the same row and did all the work together, and they both took part in the events together. And he also reminded his teacher, Padmanabhaya sir, who was their class teacher. And their class teacher used to appreciate them when they got the first prize in district science fair. And also see here, I remember how we went on a picnic to Koil Sagar. Even they went to picnic, where? To Koil Sagar. There, what did they do? They went for boating. And also our tour to Srishailam, even they went to Srishailam also. It was a memorable one. And still I remember the green hills full of trees that almost touched the sky. I remember the roaring of the Krishna River at the dam. And also he's reminding the roaring of the Krishna River at the dam. And there is nothing here. And he's talking about the city life where he is living. He is telling that here there is nothing like that, and I wonder at my child. Means when he see his child, he wonder at his child's silence. Why? Because he always sits in front of the computer and plays games and never caring for anyone. So what do his child do? He sits in front of the computer and he always plays games, and he never care, means he never bother for anyone. I remember the happy moments when our uncle visited us. He brought toys and fruits for us. Our aunt brought me a new dress for Dasara. How we enjoyed Diwali. Still I hear the sounds of crackers. I can see the rockets flying into the sky, making the night full of light. Where are those days? My child doesn't know his uncle or aunt. For him, uncle and neighbor are the same. So he's thinking about the happy moments when their uncle visited their home during his childhood. His uncle brought toys and fruits for them, and also their aunt brought a new dress for Dasara, and even they enjoyed a lot in Diwali. Means still he can hear the sounds of the crackers which they have blasted during Diwali. And I can see the rockets flying into the sky, making the night full of light. So where are those days? He's telling that all those happy days are now, we can't find them. And he's telling my child doesn't know his uncle or aunt. So his child don't know who is his uncle and who is his aunt. So for him, uncle and a neighbor are the same. Sometimes I think of our childhood days. I think of grandparents, uncles, brothers, sisters. We miss them. We miss the joy of the family. We miss their company. We are missing many things in this busy life. So he is telling that when he think about his childhood days, he think about his grandparents, uncles, aunts, brothers, sisters, and he missed them a lot. And he also missed the joy of the family and also their company. So missing many things, so he is missing so many things in this busy life. So Suresh, I don't know where those gardens have gone. Those fairy tales, those fruits, those words of love and affection. We have lost our real life in this unreal world. So he's telling that where those gardens, those fairy tales, fruits, those love and affection, relationships have gone. Now we have lost, he's telling that we have lost our real life in this unreal world. Anyhow, I am happy that I have found time to write you. Please come to me. Let's remember our childhood days of joy. So he's telling, I am happy that I have found some time to write a letter to you. And he is asking his friend to come to his home to remind their childhood days of joy again. So this is what the letter is about. And I think you all have understood it. There are some activities here. See here, writing part. Observe any 5 families in your neighborhood and draw your conclusions, advantages and disadvantages of living in a joint or nuclear family. So students, this is your homework. Already I have made you to write about the family advantages, disadvantages, and what is a joint and what is a nuclear family. So I think you have written it. So what you do is you have to observe any 5 families in your neighborhood and you have to write the advantages and disadvantages of living in a joint and nuclear family. This is your homework. And hard words: apologize, Hyderabad, unfortunately, Manikonda, fairy tales, warriors, Microsoft, programmer, system analyst, disgusting, swimming, apartment, appreciated, Koil Sagar, Sri Shailam, crackers, neighbor, affection, childhood. So these are the hard words, and see the meanings. Apologize means say sorry for doing something wrong. Fairy tales means stories about fairies and magic. Warriors, person who fight in a battle or war. Faded, less bright. Disgusting, extremely unpleasant. Gilli Danda, a rural sport of India played with a short stick and a long stick. Apartment, a set of rooms for living in, usually built in stairs. unheeded, noticed but then ignored, appreciated, recognized the good qualities, caring, feeling that something is important, moment, time or occasion. And your home assignment is write hard words and meanings in your notebooks. So students, I have given you hard words and meanings separately. I want you to write them neatly in your notebooks and I want you to send me in time. We'll be completing the remaining part of the lesson in our next session. Thank you. Have a good day.